paint paintings. The only problem was my parents didn't support the fact that I wanted to be a professional artist. They said, Neil, you need to get a real job. So I became a magician. What I did is I drew inspiration from that part of my life, and I created this next trick. Now, we're going to pull this up on the camera here so you can see. I took a little Sharpie marker, and I drew a little magician on the back here. Now, I didn't say I was a good artist, all right? But you'll see there's the stick figure magician here. You got his little top hat, deck of cards, a cannon, and he's under a circus tent. Now, I know this doesn't make much sense right now, but it will in a few moments, because this stick figure magician, he performs one heck of a card trick. So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna bring the house lights up a little bit, and we're all gonna come together as a group to select a playing card. So this gentleman right here, what's your name? Derek. In the deck of cards, we have red cards and we have black cards. So the reds are the hearts and the diamonds. Black is spades and clubs. Nothing funny. Whatever you choose, we're going with. Is it going to be a red card or a black card? Black card. Do me a favor. Point to somebody that you don't know. Somebody in the room that you do not know. Black card. Right here. This gentleman here? Yes. So he's chosen a black card. In a deck of cards, there's spades and there's clubs. Your choice. Nothing funny. Whatever you name, we're going with. Spades or clubs? This guy in the purple shirt, yeah. Spades, point to somebody that you don't know. Right next to you, perfect, not too far away. Spades, what's your name? Rihanna or Brianna? Brianna, Brianna, in a deck of cards, there's low cards, and there's what we call, there's number cards and what we call face cards. So the number cards are ace through 10, and then the face cards are jack, queen, or king. So is it gonna be a number card or a face card, your choice? A face card, so a jack, queen, or a king, keeping in mind he chose spades. Point to one last person, Rihanna. Somebody you don't know. Who are you going with? Right behind you, this guy right here. Keeping in mind, Rihanna chose a face card. That's gonna be a jack, queen, or a king. Keeping in mind it's a spade, your choice. Jack of spades, queen of spades, or the king of spades. King of spades. Now, here's the thing. I don't want you to leave here today regretting your choice. And I also don't want you to think this is a reverse psychology thing. I'm going to give you one last chance to change your mind. It can be the king of spades, or you can change it at the last moment. But whatever it is, it's your final answer. King of spades. We'll go through so everybody can see here on the big screen the freely chosen king of spades. Now, I told you all I'd drawn that little stick figure magician on the back of the deck. What I didn't tell you is that I also drew him on this card and this card. Actually, as a matter of fact, I drew him on every single card in the deck, except on each drawing, he's a little bit different. You see, this deck of cards, it works like one of those flip books that we had as a kid. Remember those? You flip through them, they come to life. Well, I want you to watch my stick figure magician closely as he performs for you the world's most dangerous card trick. Remember, collectively, we came together as a group to freely select the King of Spades. Check this out. The stick figure magician. He loads himself into the cannon, throws the cards into the air, blasts out the cannon, catches one card midair. I'm hoping your card, the King of Spades. Any questions? Now, after I fell out of love with art and into love with the art of magic, it wasn't until I was 10 years old that I started to take my magic very seriously. You see, whenever a magic show would come to town, I would always beg my parents to go and see it. And fate would have it, when I was 10 years old, I would meet a magician by the name of Cliff Harden. Now, Cliff, he was a local magician, and the first time I saw Cliff perform, he did a trick with the four aces and a deck of cards that absolutely blew my mind. I had no idea how he did it. After the show, I begged my mom if she would be willing to ask Cliff if he would be willing to give me magic lessons. And it just so happened that Cliff was going to be opening a magic school. It was going to be 2 hours every Saturday for 8 weeks, and it was going to be for 5 or 6 students. I showed up the first Saturday, God honest true story, I was the only kid who showed up. And 8 weeks turned into 15 years. Cliff was much more than a mentor to me. He was a grandfather figure, and he was my best friend. I wouldn't be here standing performing in front of you all right now if it wasn't for Cliff. And thank you. And unfortunately, Cliff did pass away a few years back, but every show in his memory, whenever I get the chance, I do this one for him. So I hope you enjoy. This is my mentor Cliff's favorite ace trick. On board. Did we all have fun this afternoon? Yeah.